This is the Hillsboro Cannery that was owned by Bertrand Mailing, our great-grandfather. It's kind of ironic. I never knew when we lived in Hillsboro that this cannery was owned by our family. But this is the cannery that we sent the strawberries to when we picked them when we were kids. I'm going to read just a little bit of information that Mom gave me about the cannery. Ray Mailing and Company was organized by B.E. Mailing and H.W. Ray as an Oregon corporation in 1920 to operate the old Hillsboro Canning Company plant, which in turn was originally started in about 1914 under the name of O.J. Gillett & Son. The original Hillsboro plant was located on 10th Street on the eastern edge of town, and after acquisition by Ray Mailing and Company, the new plant was built on the present location in 1920. This was strictly a canning operation, and the first freezing operation wasn't begun until 1929 when a contract was entered into with GE Foods. From that time on, both frozen and goods have been packed at the Hillsboro plant. In 1934, the Hillsboro plant was sold to General Foods, and B.E. Mailing and Company was organized as a 100% owned subsidiary of General Foods to operate this plant. It was operated in the name of B.E. Mailing, Inc. from 1934 until December 31 of 1945, when the company was dissolved.
He was a famous trumpet man from our Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was a top man at his craft, but then his number came up and he was gone with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowing reveille. He's a boogie boogie bugle boy of Company B. They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam. It really brought him down because he couldn't jam. The cap seemed to understand, because the next day the cap went out and drafted a band. And now the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's a boogie boogie bugle boy of Company B. A toot, a toot, a toot till he had a toot. He blows an A to the bar in boogie rhythm. He can't blow a note unless a bass and guitar are playing with him. He makes the company jump when he plays reveille. He's a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. He was a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. And when he plays boogie woogie bugle, he was busy as a buzz bee. And when he plays, he makes the company jump A to the bar. He's a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. Do-do-do-do-riada, do-riada, do-do-do, he blows an A to the bar. Can't blow a note if the bass and guitar isn't with him. The company jumps and he plays reveille. He's a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
Dan Grandma didn't do a whole lot of talking at this point, so I thought I'd read an article that was written in 1976 about the Mailing Estate, which was built on Little Whale Cove. Black marble fireplaces, an especially designed bathtub, an intercon system, a penthouse, and a spectacular view of the ocean are all among the spectacular features which helped to make the Mailing Estate one of the most fantastic showplaces on the Central Oregon coast. Built in the 1930s by the late B.E. Mailing of Hillsboro, the mansion is just south of Depot Bay at Little Whale Cove. It stands today as a reminder of times past and the accomplishments of one of Oregon's most prominent businessmen. Stepping inside the mansion, one is immediately at home, for despite its bigness, the house has a warm feeling which was surely intended by its builder. Melissa and Sid Neal of Toledo recall knowing the late Mrs. Mailing as one of the nicest persons you could ever hope to meet. Mrs. Neal also remembers the beautiful furniture at the home, some of which was made for the house and is still there. Depot Bay resident Stan Allen also knew Mrs. Mailing and has nothing but kind words for the woman. He and his wife rented the former gardener's cottage after World War II. They lived there for 2 years. The penthouse is said to be used mostly by Mrs. Mailing as her private retreat. The house has 3 floors and a basement. The playroom, food storage facilities, including a walk-in freezer and wine closet, bathroom facilities, and a furnace room are all in the basement. The house is heated by steam. The main floor includes an entry, living room, dining room, den, kitchen, pantry, and butler's pantry. The second floor has 4 bedrooms and 3 bathrooms. The master bedroom is large with its adjacent bathroom made especially for Mr. Mailing. He's reported to have weighed about 300 pounds. The entire house has wool carpeting with black on the main floor, brown upstairs, and a light green on the third floor. I'm going to stop reading just for a minute because this is one of the few shots where you can see the house and the land leading up to it. That's the house off in the distance. You can just barely see it. Back to the article. To the south, the house offers a spectacular view of the ocean and a trail that leads to Little Whale Cove, where Mailing envisioned a swimming area. The bathroom in the basement was finished like a bathhouse to accommodate swimmers. The estate was owned by the Mailing family until about 1946. After that, the property changed hands several times until the purchase by the Halverson firm about a year ago. Essex Mailing was a prominent Northwestern food canner and packer who in 1929 pioneered the quick frozen process of preserving fruits and vegetables. The story goes that while attending a food processor's convention on the East Coast, he was introduced to Mr. Birdseye, who related his process for freezing fresh fish. Mailing was interested and thought that if it was possible with fish, why not fruits or vegetables? With Birdseye's help, he developed the quick freeze process. Mailing was a director of the Commercial National Bank of Hillsboro, a member of the Portland Arlington Club, a Rotarian, a Republican, that's important, and a member of the Congressional Church. His advancement in society and the business world is a true success story, starting when he began as an office boy and advanced to freight and passenger agent with the Chicago Northwestern Railway. Mailing was born July 19, 1888 in Brewer, Missouri. He was married to Myrtle Mahone June 23, 1909, and they had 1 daughter, Eleanor Virginia, Mrs. T.W. McDonald. Mailing died May 1, 1942 at his home on Little Whale Cove. He was buried May 3 in Hillsboro.